Now, what is the scale of a map? A scale of a map is the ratio between the actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. Do you know, student, every map has a scale. It is a horizontal line which is marked off in miles, in kilometers, in meters and centimeters. And many units of distance measurement are there. To calculate the distance between the two places, we need to know the scale of a map. And it looks like a ruler. It looks like a scale that we use in our mathematics. It is a horizontal line, as you can see in the diagram also, which is labeled with some units of distance measurement, like kilometers, meters, centimeters, miles, etc. So it is a ratio between the actual distance on the ground and distance shown on the map. Now suppose if I want to calculate the distance between Delhi and Panipat, then can I show the full 92 kilometers, which is the actual distance between Delhi and Panipat, on a small sheet of paper called map? No, it is not possible. So what we do, we assume that if I draw a line of 1 centimeter, then it will be equal to 5 kilometers. As map is very small in size, so we cannot show the 92 kilometers of distance between Delhi and Panipat on map. So we assume that if I draw a line of 1 centimeter, then it will be equal to 5 kilometers. Like this, we use to calculate or measure the distance between the two places on the map. Now, the third language of map is the conventional symbols. Conventional symbols are used to show the natural or man-made features. What are natural features now? Natural features are those features which we get from the nature. And man-made features means the features or the things that are made by the man. Now, what are some natural things which we get from the nature? Peaks, then rivers, then mountain passes are there, plateaus are there, plains are there, deserts are there, and many things like rivers, oceans, water bodies, continents. These are the natural features. And what are the man-made features? The things that are made by man, like hospitals, roads, boundaries, then what else is there? Roads are there, railways are there, bridges are there, flyovers are there, then temples are there, then dams are there. There are so many things which are made by man. And natural things are those which we get from the nature. So these symbols are used to show the natural or man-made things on map. As you know, we can't show a dam, which is a very, very big, huge in size. We can't show such a huge size dam on a map. So we use these symbols to show that the Bhakra Nangal Dam, which is in Punjab, is located here on the map of India by making the symbol of a dam. There are so many symbols. I have given a small list to you people. There are so many symbols which we use on the map for showing different things. Dam. Now if I show the Golden Temple, which is in Amritsar, then I will make the symbol of temple in Punjab, and I will locate that this is the Golden Temple in Amritsar. So these symbols are used to show the man-made and the natural features on the earth. Now the last language of map is the colors. Colors, different colors are used to show the different things on map, and these different things are the physical features of the on the earth. Like I have told you that different, you can see here the map of physical map of India, which on which the different colors are used to show the different things. And this color scheme is mainly used on the physical map only. Like brown color here is used to show the mountains, green color is used to show the plains, Yellow color is used to show the deserts. Light brown color is used to show the plateaus. And this blue color is used to show the water bodies. So this is the color scheme which is mainly used on the physical maps to show the physical features on the earth. So this is what all about the different languages of map. And every map has a key. A map usually has a key, which gives the details of the map, which gives the scale of a map and explain what the various symbol represents. As we have done many times in fourth class also, when we have done the map of soils, the type of soils found in India, then we located the different types of soils in different states and we use different colors for different types of soils. Remember students, we use black color for black soil, we use red color for red soil, we use alluvial soil, green color for showing alluvial soil, we use brown color for showing the mountain soils, right? Then different types of colors are used to show the physical features on the earth. So this is what about the second chapter.